Amen.
We're going to thank God for our lives, for everything since morning. The Lord has kept us. Mm-hmm. Nothing bad has happened to us. We're going to thank God for His mercies, for His grace. Many people wish to have it this way, but they are not having it. It's such a great opportunity for you and I to be alive today. It's not by our own strength. It's not by our mind, by the power of God.
Amen.
Open up your mouth and thank God.
Father, we thank you. Father, we love you. We bless and we honor you because you've been so kind. You've been so good. You've been so faithful to us. Great is your faithfulness. Great is your faithfulness. Your mercies are new every morning. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We give you praise. We give you worship. We give you honor. We adore you, Lord. Jesus, take the glory. 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 Makola ba 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 ba. Shake it, la 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 ba. Shake it, la la ba ba ba. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We bless you, Lord. We exalt you, Jesus. We honor you, Lord. Glory hallelujah. Lord,
that we have done.
Glory,
by your grace and your mercy,
we worship you. We worship you. We honor you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Glorify your name for your benefits of our life. We thank you for your compassion. We thank you for your grace of our lives, O God. Thank you for all that you've done and what you're still going to do in our lives, O God. We bless you, Jesus. We bless you, Jesus. We bless you, Jesus. We bless you, Jesus. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. We honor you, Lord. We honor you, Lord, because you've been faithful to us, O God. You've been so faithful to us, O God. Glory, hallelujah. Thank you for all that you've done and what you're still going to do. Makula mama sinda na mashina. Yala la 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 mama. We bless you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. We bring our hearts before God to set through us, for the Bible say, all have sinned and therefore short fall of the glory of God, according to the word of God in Romans 3:23. Let us bring our hearts before God, for the Bible says, if we say we have not sinned against Him, we are being a liar and the truth is not in us. Bring our hearts before the Lord, for His word says, when we confess our sins, He is a faithful and a just God to wash us and cleanse us, purify and sanctify us from all unrighteousness. Bring your hearts before
in
the Lord
name
and tell
of
God
Jesus.
To step through you. If there be any
Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we bring our heart before you, O God, that let your word zoom our hearts. Let your word zoom our hearts, O God, and search us. Father, your word is the searching machine, O God, that sheds the intent of our feeling, the intent of our heart. Hearts, O God, the thoughts of our mind. Father, let everything be open before you, O God. Father, make everything clearer to us, O God. As we enter into your word, O God, we pray that your word will change us. We pray that your word will set us free. In the name of Jesus, sanctify us, O God. Cleanse us, O God. Wash us, O God. Make us fear, O God. Make us fear, O God. Make us fear, O God. Make me holy, Jesus. Make me holy, Jesus. Make me holy, Jesus. Makura baba baba. Let your word, let your word, let your word, O God. We plead the blood. We plead your blood for forgiveness. We plead your blood for forgiveness, O God. Forgive us and cleanse us from all unrighteous acts, O God. Wash us and sanctify us, O God. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, let your blood, let your blood, let your blood, the blood of Jesus, it will never lose its power, it will never lose its power, let your blood set us free. Makundalala masinanandala bashikaya mama. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Makula baba baba. Whilst you ever said and thought.
We pray. Right now, we're going to invite the Holy Spirit to take charge, to take control of whatever we are going to do. Our strength cannot do anything. We invite the Lord to strengthen us. He's the Lord that gives us understanding, knowledge, and wisdom. That whatever we listen here today, we will not depart from it. We will. It will be upon our hearts. We hide it upon our hearts that we will not forget it and sin against the Lord. Open up your mouth and ask.
Father, in the name of Jesus, we invite you, Spirit of God. Sweet Spirit, have your way. Gentle Spirit, come and have your way. Holy Spirit, come and have your way. Holy Spirit, come and fill this place. Holy Spirit, come and speak your word. Change us as we stand for you. Holy Spirit, come and speak your word. Holy Spirit, come and make a way. Come, Holy Spirit, come, Holy Spirit, we need you. Sweet Spirit, Spirit of understanding, Spirit of wisdom, Spirit of might and power. Let it fall on us, let it fall on us, O God. Demonstrate your will and reveal your plans and your purpose in our hearts, O God. Let your power be made known unto us, O God. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Let it be. Let it be, Lord.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
In the name of Jesus' name.
We're going to thank God and we're going to ask God to give us wisdom, knowledge, and understanding that the man of God, whatever he's going to say here today, will not depart from our heart, body, soul, and spirit, that we will walk with the word, we'll eat with the word. The word will be written at the tablet of our hearts, that we will not sin against God. Open up your mouth and
in the name of Jesus, Lord, prepare a place for your word in our hearts. Prepare a place of your word in our hearts, O God, that nothing of the enemy will be able, no sting of the enemy, no confusion, no distorting, nothing would take away your word from our hearts. Your word will we hide in our heart that we may not sin against you, Lord. In the name of Jesus, the tablets of our hearts, O God, write your word. Write your word. Write your word. We give the preeminence of your word in our mind, in our soul, and in our spirit. In the name of Jesus Christ, anything that will revolt against your word, we crush it in Jesus' name. Demolish every idea, demolish every thought, every feeling and emotion that will stand on your way, O God, to compete against your word in our heart. Destroy it, O God, in the name of Jesus, by the power of the Holy Spirit. We lean upon you, Lord God. Thank you, Lord.
In
Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
We're going to ask God to give us the strength to destroy the plans of the enemy, for the Bible says in Ephesians 1:12 that we rest not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, powers of darkness. Tonight, we're going to ask the strength of God to destroy any plans of the enemy, principalities, powers.
In the name of Jesus, we stand against every foul spirit, confusion, spirit, commotion, and distortion, O God, spirit of disturbance, we bind you in the name of Jesus. You have no place in our midst, confusion. Just anything that will cause our meeting to lose its value in the sight of God, we demolish it in Jesus' name. We bring every argument and intention of men to nothing. We bring the wisdom of men, O God, and the distortion plans of the enemy, we come against it in Jesus' name. We dismantle every platform that the enemy has built, O God, to ruin our meeting. Tonight we come against it in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, let the word that bring strength, let the word proceed unhindered, O God. Let the word proceed unhindered, O God. In the name of Jesus, let Christ arise and let every enemy be scattered. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name.
you.
Amen.
Amen. Let us pray to commit our brethren that are on the way into the hands of God. That the Lord God will bring them safely.
Father, we bring our brothers and sisters on Facebook. The brothers and sisters on Zoom. We soak them in the blood. We cover them in the name of Jesus. We cover them in the name of Jesus. Father, we cry. Father, we cry. You will be revealed. You will be revealed. You will be revealed, O God. In the name of Jesus. Mandolobo sika bala baba yanda. Ora mama mama shina na 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 mandiana. Thank you, Jesus. All the glory, Lord. Oh, Jesus. Oh, the blood of Jesus. Oh, the blood of Jesus. It washes what us know. Of Jesus, Lord, we thank you for the blood of Jesus. It washes what us know.
Blessed be the name
of the Lord. He's worthy. Worthy to be praised and adored. So we lift our holy hands. He won our call. Sing, blessed be the name. Blessed be the name. Blessed be the name. Oh, the Shadows, as old as you are, as old as you are, you never change, never change. Shadows, as old as you are, as old as you are, you. Never change the strength of it. Yes, Lord, as old as you are, as old as you are, Lord, you never change, never change. Yeah, as old as you are, as old as you are. Let me be as good and precious silver purify my heart. Let me be as gold pure, redeemed, refined as fire. My heart one desire is to be holy, set apart for you, Lord. I choose to be holy, set apart for you, my master. I'm ready to do your will.
You are the shelter
that I seek. You are my all in all. Seeking you as a precious jewel, Lord, to give up, I'll be a fool. You are my all in all. Jesus, the Lamb of God, the Lamb of God, worthy is your name. Worthy is your name. Worthy is your name. For you are glorious. Singing glory, glory, glory to you, the Lamb. Let's worship the Lord our God. Begin to worship the Lord and tell him how much we love him. Express your love to the Lord. Tell him how much you love him, how much you appreciate him. Thank him that he has brought you to this far. Some of the people that you began life with, some are dead. Some of the people that you were laboring this battle with, some are dead and gone. But you are alive, you are alive, you are alive. Shina la 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 la, sinna la la. Yeah la 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 la, we cannot worship you, Lord. We cannot stop worshiping you, Lord. Yeah la la la, ma 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 ma, inna la ma ma. We bow down and we lay our crown at the feet of Jesus. So we bow down, we bow down, and we lay cry holy, holy. We cry holy, holy, holy. We cry holy. We cry holy, holy, holy. We cry holy, holy. Holy is the Lord. He holy is the Lord. Let's sing again. We bow down. We bow down. And we lay our crowns at the feet of Jesus. We bow down. We bow down. And we lay our crowns at the feet of Jesus. We cry holy. We cry holy. We cry, oh, holy is the Lord. He holy is the Lord. Father, we love you. Son of God, we adore you. Prince of Peace, we worship you for another opportunity to study your word together. Here we are, O God, we bring our heart before you. Feed us, O God. Teach us your ways and show us your will. By the entrance of your word, bring understanding. By the entrance of your word, bring illumination. Father, let your word change us, O God. It's only in your word that we can be delivered. Deliver us from the power of sin. Reveal to us the strategy of the enemy. Expose the wickedness of the enemy to us, that we might know how to live our life here on earth. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Understanding spiritual warfare has been our series in the time past. And today too, we are not going to deviate from it. We are going to pursue the same topic. So, tonight, join with me, with brothers and sisters. Brothers and sisters from Europe, from Spain, from Italy, from Germany. Brothers and sisters all over. We're going to study the Word of God, and we have family friends and brothers also on Facebook that are also enjoying. We have others also on End Time Radio UK. Those who have tuned in, they are also going to enjoy the same thing. So in our past studies, we've been dealing with the strategy of the enemy. To be honest with you, what Christian needs to know, it's not only about Jesus Christ, but we need to know about the devil also. There are some people that they don't believe in the devil. One of my in-laws, he told me, I don't believe in the devil. I said, wow, you amazed me. A person who doesn't believe in the existence of the devil, a person who doesn't believe the works of the kingdom of darkness, that person, either he has been slaved, he is a slave to the devil already, and therefore Satan has blindfolded his ears and his mind, his eyes, that he will see everything around him, yet he will not say that it is the devil. He said that it is chances and choices come from himself. I don't believe in the devil. I said, all right, how pity are you? We've been talking about how Satan uses our own mind, our own wishes, and our own feelings to destroy us. The Bible once said a man's enemy is his own household members. When the Bible said the household members, he is not talking about witches and wizards in your family. Rather, he is talking about things within your system. Things within your system. Your eyes, your ears, your nose, your mouth, your mind, your legs, your hands, your body. So basically, your body parts can become an instrument of the devil unaware.
Amen.
Amen. Satan can use your body parts as an instrument against you. And you might be ignorant of it. But Satan will not take advantage over we born-again believers, heaven-seekers, members. People who have set our heart on course to make heaven by hook or crook. We are willing to pay the price. We are willing to say that we are ready. Wherever you send us, we will go for you. Such people, God will not hide his secrets. God will not hide the secret of the devil neither from them. Kindly turn your Bible with me as we bring our studies gradually to a position that Luke chapter number 22, Luke chapter 22, Luke chapter 22. Satan can ask the permission of God to sift Christians. Satan can ask permission from God to attack a born-again believer. And Jesus can allow that. That sounds very, very harsh. Luke chapter number 22, verse 31. Jesus said this to Peter. Please read for us.
I read in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Simon, Simon, Satan has asked you to test all of you as a farmer takes his wheat. Amen.
Amen. Continue.
I have prayed that you will not lose your faith.
Uh-huh.
Help your brothers be stronger when you come back to me. But Peter said to Jesus, Lord, I am ready to go with you to prison, even to die with you. 34. But Jesus said, Peter, before the cockerel crows this day, you will say three times that you don't know me.
Amen. Peter, Peter, Satan have sought a permission to destroy. What is permission? When somebody seek permission from somebody, what does it mean? Seeking a permission from somebody.
Asking for permission.
Asking for permission. What does it mean? Seeking somebody's approval. Uh-huh.
Yeah. Seeking for authorization.
Seeking for authorization. Seeking for consent for a person in the high authority to allow you to do something. Auntie Barbara, what does it mean? Today I'm going to work with you very much, so be ready.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
For consent, you know, to do something.
Seek for consent. In other words,
attention.
Come again, Sister Vic.
For attention.
Asking for attention. Asking for somebody, can you give me attention? Can you give me attention? In other words, what I'm doing, you are going to patronize with me.
With awareness of.
I want you to be aware. I want you to be involved. I need your approval. Give me the approval to do this. Give me the backing. Give me the. Satan can go to Jesus Christ. Is it true? We've seen in the Bible. The children are having a nice time above there. That's fine. That's fine. They are worshiping God up there. That's nice. Satan can ask permission when our lives are not in the right path with God. A Christian, if you are not living in the standard and the levels, the standard that Christ wants you to live, you open the door for Satan to seek an approval. Be careful. You can't live your life as an ignorant believer. You can't be just a religious person going to church for going sake. Be much devoted. Be much involved with the things of God. I know the average Christian thinks that only a pastor must fast and pray every day. Only a pastor must live a righteous life. Only a pastor must live a life dedicated unto God. And that is one of the falsehood and deception of the enemy. Talking about the deception of the enemy. Only pastor's wife and pastor's children should live as Christian. Oh, how can a pastor do this? When we come to elders, oh, how can an elder do this? And for a church member can do whatever he thinks. And that is false. The Bible says that we are royal priesthood. Everyone among Christendom has the same fiber. In other words, when they put all to test, we all must come out with the same results.
Amen.
Amen. The reason why our Christian life is not reaching the maximum point where we can overcome Satan is we think we are not responsible for those things. I don't need to study my Bible as a pastor may be studying his Bible every now and then because I don't need to preach every day. If you are preaching every day to people at your workplace, you will study your Bible, isn't it? The preparation, the test, the reward God is going to give to us equally. Not because you are a pastor, not because he is bishop, no. But because you obeyed the voice of God. Let us come out from that mentality. And this is the Christianity that we want to project to you. Because this is the Christianity that will attract divine reward. Christianity that lives for God every day. Christianity that exempts himself or herself from sin every day. Jesus said, Peter, repeatedly, Satan had wanted to sift you like a wheat. Sift you. Satan wanted to attack you. Satan wanted to destroy you. That is the point. He wanted to destroy you. Any permission that Satan seeks from God, what do you think the permission is for? Number one,
to test you.
To put us into temptation. Satan doesn't test us. He tempts us. He has not taught us anything to test us. He tempts us. There's a difference between test and temptation. Temptation is a driving force. Challenges, let me throw it to you. Sorry. When I say temptation and test are different. Sister, I want somebody. Okay, among the Zoom, let somebody come out. Sister Lucris, what do you understand by temptation and test?
I don't know how I'm going to put it, but then temptation is something that wants to make you fall. You know, it's something that is in front of you and makes you fall into sin, whereas a test is to strengthen your faith.
Amen.
So that's the difference. And a test is to see how far you've gone. It's like, in French we say a proof. So I don't know what's the word in English.
Mm-hmm. Assessment.
I don't know if Sister Love can interpret a proof, but it's like some, it's like steps of war, but then you are going stronger and stronger.
That is good. That is good. I love that. I welcome that. Sister Esther, what is the difference between tests? What Sister Lucrece said is exactly. So say something in the similar.
Yes, please. Sister Lucrece has said it all.
Said it, the little one you know.
Yes, I agree with her. Test is like, it is to promote us. Because when you go to school, you have to be tested before you can be promoted to the other class. So test is to promote us, but the temptation, if you are not careful, you can fall in the temptation. So,
Amen.
Ability of something you can do, and temptation is something unwillingly, something you are not ready, but it just happened to you accidentally, you get yourself involved without coming out. It's like you are not aware, you don't like what you're doing, but you just find yourself doing that thing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's what I
mean. Mm-hmm. Okay, that's fine. Love, do you want to say something?
A test is to assess the knowledge of something.
Uh-huh.
Or to see how strong or how firm you have believed.
How far you've come.
Something, yeah. How far you have grown.
Mm. Test to assess our spiritual maturity. How mature we have become. What about temptation?
That's a temptation. It's a way to bid you into sin, but then it's also sort of assess your strength on God's side.
Mm.
You know, when we get tempted, God doesn't stop it.
Mm-hmm.
But it also makes him see how far we have grown, or how far we have believed, or how far we have yielded to the enemy. So it doesn't stop temptation. So for God's side, when we get tempted, he sees our strength, whether we still have a desire for that thing.
Mm.
So it's also a way of assessment, but I just...
Temptation reveals what is in us. Test assess us. It's assessment. Temptation reveals what is in us. Either it is evil or it is right. And I always say that temptation is a desire, a sinful desire in you, looking for an opportunity. And when opportunity comes, it's a temptation.
Hallelujah.
Amen, Sister Babs.
Can I say something?
Yes, Papa? Please.
I'll give an example with the temptation and the test.
Mm-hmm.
When we look at Abraham, he was tested
mm-hmm.
of his the faith that he said he has in God.
Mm-hmm.
He was tested. And as of Peter, he was tempted.
Mm.
So if you look at the two people, there's a difference. Mm-hmm. Peter was tempted to, you know, to come out from Christ,
mm.
to fall, light. But Abraham... it was God himself who tested his faith.
Mm.
And in a way, Abraham and Job, I think they all stand the same thing. They were tested of their faith in God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Hello, sister. Yeah, amen.
Yeah. For temptation, I bring it down.
Uh-huh.
Let's say I am fasting.
Uh-huh.
And then there is food.
Uh-huh.
I can be tempted to go and eat.
And break this fasting, uh-huh?
Yes, and then break my fasting. Why I have not reached the time to break it?
Mm.
And then also for test, let's say, you know, I've lost my job or I don't have money.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I can be tested that somebody will come, "Oh, Vicky, I have connection.
Mm-hmm.
If you do this, if you do that, you have money.
Mm.
So why don't you join this one so that you can get money?"
Mm.
And I say, "No, I'm not doing it."
Mm.
That is test.
Mm.
Amen.
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 Temptation always comes for our moral purpose. Morally is where temptation always builds up. Morally. How do we stand with God morally? We'll be tempted. We can be tested with our intellectual standard of something, our level of understanding of something. But temptation is always taking you out of the hands of God. Just bring you out of the hands of God. So Jesus was telling Peter that Satan had wanted to tempt you. And let's see the temptation that Jesus was talking about. He said, "Behold, Satan had this desire to have you, that he may sift you as a wheat. But I have prayed for you, that your faith will fail not." So it's all about faith. Temptation and test, they all come because of our faith in God. I think this afternoon we talked about Sadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. What was it? Was it temptation or test? It was a test. It was a test. For a mature believer, everything that Satan can bring on us could be a test. God can bring a test. Satan can also bring a test.
Yes.
Satan can test us. And in any way, there is a danger to fall. And when you fall, you are falling. Temptation normally plays up with our moral lifestyle. Straight away, temptation is very serious than test.
I think we get temptation when after you have received the word of God.
After you receive the word of God, the test comes.
Yeah, for instance, you believe in holiness.
Uh-huh.
After that, somebody will come and try to talk you out. Maybe your husband, who is not a believer,
mm-hmm.
will do everything to convince you to let you know that what you are following is wrong.
Mm.
So over here, it assesses how much you have held on to the faith.
Mm-hmm.
So over here, although it is negative, but it also assesses you.
Mm-hmm.
If you look at Adam and Eve,
mm-hmm.
the Lord told them, don't eat this fruit. You can touch every fruit in the garden except this one.
Mm-hmm.
You see, they received the word of God first, and then the temptation came afterwards that they should go and eat that fruit. It doesn't matter. So after you have received the word of God, Satan also comes with his to let you know that to assess whether what you heard
is true or not,
or you received it or not. So after obedience or after the word of God has been given, temptation will follow afterwards.
Amen.
Amen.
Did you hear her?
Yes, please.
Okay. Other than that, I will suggest that she come a little bit closer since she's a little bit far. Sister Lucris, please, your hands is up before we continue. No, you sit there.
I did not hear anything.
You didn't hear anything?
No.
Okay. So please come forward if you want to contribute.
Okay. Amen.
Sister Lucris, please.
Yes, please. I'd like to add also, I think there's a very fine line between the two.
Sorry?
I think there's also a very fine line between the two.
Okay.
Between the potential and test. Because when I look at, for example, based on what Sister Love said, and when we see the case of David, was that when he fell into sin? Yeah, with Bathsheba. Was that a temptation or a test? Because I believe a woman played a part in that.
Absolutely.
So in that David case, so was that? So it may come in both ways as well. So I think there's a there's a line that is very minor between the two. You know, otherwise we may even come in together, like temptation and test. Because I don't know, how do you think about it?
The Bathsheba case was a temptation. Mm-hmm. Anytime that it comes to moral life, it's not a test, it's a temptation. That you fall morally. And that sin will affect your relationship with God. And most of the time, tests. When you fail a test, there is still another chance for you.
Mm-hmm.
But when you fail in temptation, you are fallen. You are gone. When you fail in temptation, during the temptation, your spiritual eyes is taken off. Because anytime temptation comes, it tempts you to deny God. Take it from me, sir. And like I said, most of the time, temptation comes because we have the desire, sinful desire in us that attract the tempter to come.
That's another definition you gave, that it reveals what is in you.
Expose and reveals exactly what is in us.
You have sinful impediments or impurities in you.
Mm-hmm.
So if they are gone, like Joseph, he was strong. He didn't have that desire, or he had that desire, but he wasn't able to control himself. So he was tempted, exactly. So we all get tempted. And Jesus said, when you look at Matthew chapter 13 about the parable of the sower, he said, as a result of the word, you'll be tested for the word, and because of the word that you have received, temptation come, and because of that you were not able to endure. So Matthew 13 talks about the parable of the sower,
mm-hmm.
and it talks about you are receiving what you are getting because as a result of the word you receive.
Mm-hmm.
So because of the word, you get tested and you get temptation.
We are tested by the word of God in us.
Mm-hmm.
We are tempted by sinful desires in us.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Our desire to... Jesus was tempted. There was no sinful desire, but he was tempted with sin.
He was, yeah.
Because Satan brings temptation. Every temptation has an element of sinful cravings in them that Satan wants to use to destroy us. As we read Matthew chapter 4, Satan told Jesus Christ, if you are son of God, mm-hmm. turn this bread into, this stone into a bread. Mm-hmm. What was his intention?
Yes.
That Jesus would eat. Like Sister Vic said, that Jesus will eat at that particular time whilst he is still fasting.
Mm-hmm.
So temptation always... Sorry, yeah.
Brother Gabriel.
Yes, Sister Ifia.
Yes.
Oh, sorry. I've not come to you. When did you come?
Oh, I think about like 5 or 10 minutes ago.
That's fine. Okay, now.
Can I please...
Yes, please.
I'm going to complain about temptation.
Yes.
Well, with the little knowledge I have, what I like to say about temptation is, you know, but the devil isn't, you know, directly responsible for every temptation we face.
No.
Nor can we blame him when we
are tempted
and do wrong.
Mm-hmm.
Temptation comes to us in many ways.
Mm-hmm.
But when we give in to them, we alone are responsible for what we have done.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if you read, you know, the Bible says, you know, when you read James 1 verse 14.
Uh-huh, mm-hmm. Let's go there.
Yeah.
James 1 14.
Yes, please.
Count it all joy. Mm-hmm. When you are tempted in various kinds of temptation. Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm.
Powerful scripture. Actually,
exactly. My verse says, but we are tempted when we are drawn away and trapped by our own evil desire.
Did you hear that? When we are drawn away and trapped.
And that is why I always say, each one is tempted when by his own evil desire he is trapped away and enhanced.
Mm. James 1:14.
Yes, please.
Mm-hmm. Are you finished?
Yes, please. Amen.
Oh, so we all go through temptation. God bless you for your contributions.
Amen. Thank you.
We are all tempted by our own desires in us.
Exactly.
Let me practical here. Now, Peter was being tempted because he thought that he has already acquired. Listen to what he said. Lord, I have even decided to die with you. To manifest what was in his heart. He didn't know, he had no clue. He thought that he had already finished it. When we think that we have already acquired what it takes, that is where we fall.
Yeah.
That's why there's a scripture that said, the one that thinks he is standing, let him be very, very careful that he doesn't fall. When you come to a position that you think that you have it, be careful. Because you can fall from every level where you are.
Yeah.
The only level you can't fall is when you're lying down. So there is a song that say that he who is down fear no fall. So temptation can come to us from any angle when we are caught up.
Yeah. Yeah.
We open the door emotionally, physically, psychologically, and mentally for the devil to come. Satan will not come until he sees a door opened. Jesus said he has sought for permission to sit in. He saw an open door. Men, our highest temptation is immoral life. I know and I believe. I don't know another way to use it. That marriage is not the end of fornication. Women, normally I defend women a bit, but we do it with you. A brother shared a testimony today that holiness teaching calls a worship leader, a sister in the church. She is a worship leader and she has slept with 7 men in that church. A worship leader. How can you think that sin is in the church? They are there. We might not judge that sister that she might be sent by the devil because she can't confess by hearing restitution and say, I need to restitute. But it was weaknesses in her. She thinks that she is beautiful. And every brother comes to the church. And she is married. Not that she's not married. She's a married woman. Can tell you how far Satan can taste us. Let us kill certain desire in us. Young brothers and sisters who are listening to me or listening to us, please don't take it as an opportunity. One of the lies and deception around this attack is Satan will let you feel that it is an opportunity. It's a chance for you. Satan will let you see the benefit of it. The sinful benefit that you have during moral falling is not good. Temptation comes when we want to be promoted. We want to be seen higher than others. We are tempted to steal. We are tempted to lie to protect ourselves. When there is self-interest involved, Satan will always bring temptation. You didn't hear. When you bring self-interest in your pursuit of everything, Satan can bring temptation over there because he knows that it is self-promotion.
The door has already opened for him.
The door is open for him. Do you think that Satan will tempt us to fast? Do you think that Satan will tempt us to read the word of God? Do you think that Satan will tempt us to go on retreat? No, he won't. Separate yourself for God for a certain time? No, he won't do that. So let us be aware that this is the weapon of the enemy. He can seek permission from God to harm us. God will not allow that permission because he knows that if he allows us to go through that alone, it can destroy us. So God goes with us. He doesn't allow us to go alone. And sometimes he prepares us ahead of time before those temptations will come. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
He is much concerned about us that he will never let us fall. The only time that he will... Jesus said, but I have pleaded for you.
Yes.
I have intervened. I have worked on your behalf.
Mm-hmm.
I have done my part and you also ought to do your part. Amen.
Amen. Can I say this, Brother Gabriel, before you continue, please?
Yes, please, sister. Go ahead.
Well, thank you so much. What I would like to say is if someone is in temptation or being tempted, my thing is don't fight your temptations alone.
Don't fight it alone.
If you do, you will fail. Instead, ask God to help you by giving you the courage and the inner spirit to turn away. Being by asking Christ to come into your life, forgiving and cleansing your sins, and giving, you know, and coming to live within you by his spirit. Amen.
Amen. Don't fight your temptation alone. We are all tempted.
Yeah.
But I would say that don't bring yourself in the first place. Mama Lucy, when you say
in the first place. Mm-hmm.
Don't bring yourself in the position where you'll be tempted.
Mm-hmm.
Never promote. Never open that door.
Mm-hmm.
Fight against your desire. Fight against your emotion. And understand that when you open that door, Satan will use it. For instance, a young brother who is not married. And you know that this sister, apart from your own biological sister, every person can become a threat. Don't say, that, oh, she to me, I don't fancy her. She's not beautiful enough. Hey, brother, don't do that. It's not beauty. Many people have gone into the same situation. A gentleman that was living with a woman have given 3 children with her. And he wanted to let her go. I don't like her. I don't love her. And the question is, why have you give 3 children with this person?
With this person.
Mama, say what you want to say.
Oh, okay.
Is it gone?
Thank you. Well, sister, if I just said, I just want to break it down a bit. What I can say is when the temptation comes, it's a problem. So if the problem comes and you tackle the problem, you can never get the result. But instead, leave the problem and find a solution. The solution comes to what Sister just said, prayer and fasting, reading your Bible to that problem.
Mm-hmm.
Then God will speak to you and you find you find yourself that you have come out from the problem that came to you.
Mm-hmm.
So the solution is needed more than tackle the problem. Amen.
Amen. Let's see the steps. The solution is needed more than tackle the problem. So let's see the steps that lead us into that temptation. Number one is a desire. There is a tempter. And the tempter comes in the thoughts. It can come in our thoughts, can come in pictures, can come in desires, in feelings and emotions. So James chapter 1, our sister led us there. So open us another step where we wanted to go. But every man, when he is tempted, is drawn away for his own lust.
Yes.
Temptation draws us away by our own lust. So number one, temptation comes because there is something in us.
The lust.
It draws us away. Why does it draw us away? Lust takes us away from God. Like Sister Lucrece quoted Samuel, 2 Samuel issued of King David falling with Bathsheba. It wasn't something that might happen only one day. David might have spotted this woman for some time. Wow. Whenever you say wow, be careful. There are hidden agenda and hidden thoughts in some of our expressions.
Wow.
Sister Linda, when do we say wow?
When when you admire something.
When we admire something. Wow. That is beautiful. Wow. That is good.
Or if you've seen something that is really attractive to the eyes.
When you see something that is so catchy to the eyes.
Yeah.
So attractive. Wow. Speechless. It goes beyond every word. Sum up what is bubbling within your heart, your mind, and your soul. We are drawn away. Two things that draws us, the love of God and the love of sin. They draw like a...
And sometimes some people use the wow for appreciation. Like wow, when you appreciate something, say wow to show that you really appreciate it.
Mm-hmm. Wow. Two things, sin and love, they draws. And we have two types of love. Love for God's sake and love for our sake. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. Temptation is always involved with lust. It's involved with lust. What is the difference between love and lust? Mr. Linda, what is the difference between love?
Love means giving your heart to someone.
Mm-hmm. And lust?
And lust means giving your body to someone in form of sexual intercourse.
Okay. Lust is not only sexual intercourse, but basically 100% of them involved in that.
Yeah.
Because we have the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eye, and the pride of this life. Lust. When we give our hearts to anything falsehood is called lust. Anything which is not truth, anything which is not built on truth is lust. False evidence appearing to be truths. Sister Barbara, what is lust? Sinful desire. Okay, sister. Okay, let Auntie Barbara also come up. That's if what you're going to say, Farida had already said it. Sinful desire.
Pastor, 1 minute, I will come back. Somebody help.
Go, okay. Well, Sister Esther. I know you love your husband. What is the difference between love and lust?
Amen.
Amen.
And please, how I understand is love is giving unconditionally.
Uh-huh.
You give it out without expecting anything
But the last is something that I think the last takes something from you, but the love, you get something from love, but lust always takes something from you, because like the lust of the flesh, lust of the eyes, you see something that you love and it will draw your attention. So it will rather take the love of God from you. So
amen.
Lust always takes something from us. Amen.
Lust replaces love. Sister Ifia, what do you say about lust and love?
Amen.
Amen.
Well, to me, well, love, what I can say is, no, to kind of like care very much for,
mm-hmm.
you know, or to feel deep affection for something,
mm-hmm.
you know, to me, that's love. But then lust to me is unusually intense in desire of having something as well.
Unusual intent of desire.
Exactly.
Having something.
Yeah.
Unusual intent of a desire. It's a strong drive.
A strong drive, exactly. Yeah.
That enslaves you.
Mm-hmm. An unusual intent.
It's a force. It's very intensive.
Yeah.
It comes.
Very intensive,
and comes,
yeah.
And comes. You calm it down, it's still there.
It's still there, exactly. Mm. Yeah. Very unusual.
Love, hallelujah. You want to say something?
Oh, no, I do.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Wait, Sister Barbara is coming, okay?
Okay, and then it's also like craving for something, desiring. You are craving it. Unless you get that thing, you will never be satisfied.
Mm.
That is another
Unless you have it, you can't be satisfied. And the moment you have it, your eyes will open that it is useless. That's how
yeah.
it
happens.
Should I do this?
Let's see the outcome of love. When you love something and that is genuine, after you have had that thing, you still feel satisfied.
Yeah,
but lust, you are not satisfied after having that.
You don't get satisfaction from cravings.
Uh huh.
You desire more,
and most of the time, one thing that pains me is lust, because it's a spirit, it's a demonic spirit. It's not from God. The moment you have that thing, you see that it is useless.
Mm-hmm. But still.
You go for the next one when opportunity is given to you.
Yes. You go for it.
Only a child of God will see lust as something dirty.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't have the spirit of God, because a child of God, lust come to you to attempt to tempt you. And after he has finished his projects, he goes back and you'll be left alone.
Mm-hmm.
So we talk about the delight in viewing it, the delight in having it. Delight in seeing it. Sister Vicky, raise her hand. Sister?
Yes, Pastor. I would like to ask, you know, God told Adam that this fruit they should not eat.
Uh-huh.
And then Eve went for the fruit.
Satan tempted.
Excuse me?
She was saying that they were tempted to eat it. Uh-huh.
So I'm asking, is it a temptation or lust?
Temptation.
That was temptation. Everybody
temptation.
Say temptation.
Yeah. Satan tempts Eve, and Eve tempts Adam.
Hallelujah.
Amen, Sister Thank Barbara. You.
I didn't hear the question well, but if I heard it, she asked that when Adam and Eve sinned, was it temptation or lust?
Yes.
That one.
That was the question.
Okay. Yeah, but okay, if I can say something.
Please.
If lusted, he feasted her eye with the fruit. Oh, in a way, he was lusting after it. And Satan, you know, saw that there's a lust, because she has been told not to even, you know, go there, just leave that fruit alone. And when Satan saw, he saw an opportunity there. So he, at that time, was using her lusting after that fruit. So I think that opened that door. So before they fall into that temptation, there was a lust there. Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
That's what I wanted
to know, because I believe it was last first.
Okay.
Yeah, because after they he spoke to them, Bible said that it was very good to her eyes. Mm-hmm. She was lost. And then the desire came that let's take one and eat and see how it goes.
Amen.
So,
amen.
So she lasted after it. Amen.
Mama, you wanted to say something, okay?
Yeah, what I was trying to say is what Barbara was is telling us now means if it was last for that apple, before Satan came to her. That's why she fall into that temptation.
If
the last
yes.
is not there, she will never fall into it.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes. That is why we are trying to come into it. That anytime that we are tempted, there is lust that draws us into it. We are always driven into temptation by lust. We are not.
Please, can I ask you a question?
Yes, please.
So does it mean that before temptation will happen, lust comes first?
Exactly. That's what we are trying to say.
Before the temptation will happen.
Yes, sister. Before temptation will come, lust is always playing up. And when we talk about lust, we call the lust of the eye and the lust of the flesh, which is the boast. How you want to boast. When we come to the fleshly one, you want to boast. You want people to know it is pride coming in. Yeah? You want people to see that you are there. You want people to see that you have it. You want people to see. So Satan will use all this I want in position and drive you gradually. And it takes your eyes from the word of God and you focus on yourself. And that is where deception will finally take place.
Brother Gabriel, can I also come in, please?
Yes, please.
there is something bugging my mind a little bit.
Uh-huh.
My thing is, first of all, Satan caught and riveted Eve's attention.
Uh-huh.
Okay, she knew that snakes do not talk.
Uh-huh.
Her husband had named all the animals, including this very one.
Uh-huh.
Likely, you know, after carefully studying, you know, Genesis 2, verse 19, no doubt, Eve too had observed this cautious creature.
Mm.
So to me, my thing is, so Satan ploy'd rouse Eve's curiosity.
Mm-hmm.
It got her to focus on the one thing in all the garden that was forbidden to her.
Mm. Mm. The point is, sister Esther has a question. Does every lust comes from the eye? Yes, eye and the flesh.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
The two doors of lust into our life is what we see.
Yeah.
What we see.
Yeah.
And what we want to become.
Okay.
Blind people don't see people to date them, so they don't have much problem with lust.
No.
Sometimes you can lust by just smelling something. Or the fact that we are against. But just the smell of perfume, you can lust, even though you haven't seen the person, but the smell of perfume is so nice, and you lust after that person as well. So it can come with a smell also, I believe.
It can come with a smell. All right. Basically, the highway of lustful desire comes from our eyes. That is what the Bible have established to us.
1 John 2:15-17.
Yes.
Love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. If any man love the world, the love of the Father is not in him. 16. For all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh, and the lust of the eyes, and of the pride of life, is not of the Father, but of the world.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Amen. So in this case, before you can fall into temptation or tempted, your lust go first. You know, the devil is a spirit man. He's a spirit being. So as God knows everything in us, the same thing, the devil knows our actions. He use our actions to tempt us. Because if you see something and you like it, you love it, it shows in your body, in your mind, the way you act on that thing.
Mm-hmm.
So if somebody is there, somebody who is clever is there, the person can read you, to read your actions and bring something that will grab you from what you're looking for.
Mm.
And then the person can get you easily.
Mm.
So that's why Satan can tempt Eve. Mm-hmm. Because Satan knew that maybe in the garden of Eden, that tree, because the fruit is beautiful, as the Bible stated it, always Eve go there. Go to that tree to look at it, the way the apple is, it has to be molded. So she always go there, go around to the tree, going around to the tree to look at it. And sometimes maybe she touch it. That's why the devil knows that, if I take this fruit to tempt this woman, I will get her. Mm. That's why he used that the fruit, that apple, to tempt her.
Amen. And yes,
he got her. Amen.
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 Genesis chapter 3. Please, I want to ask a question.
Please, let's follow our procedure. If you want a question, please raise your hands, tap in, and I will call you. Don't come in between when somebody is talking. It seems we are trying to lose it again. Let's come back to the routines. Okay, ask a question, Mr. Linda.
Please, how do I tap in? How do I tap in?
Into a question.
Yeah.
If you want to ask a question, okay, what we normally do is to raise our hands.
So everybody is on video.
If no, it's not a video.
No, it's on your screen. If you look at the bottom where the names are, it says raise your hand. My one is French for that. Your one, it should say, if you go to...
Linda, later. I will actually want to do it. Let's continue.
We will show you, Sister Linda.
I will show you, please.
Okay, ask the question, Sister.
My question was seduction and temptation.
Mm-hmm.
Are they all like their seduction comes, it happened, then temptation will follow? It and lust, they all work together. Because when Mama was explaining something, what was explaining was like seduction, like the person is trying to seduce before, you know, the temptation will happen.
Okay. When Satan got to see that you have interest, he will seduce you. Seduction is something like which is being playing around. And when you allow that seduction to catch your attention, it will lead you to conception. And when you conceive that thing, then the temptation will give birth. So in other words, everything around us is communicating with us. 24/7, everything around us communicates. The cars, the houses, the drinks, the food, everything around you have a voice that communicates with your instinct. That is why some of us, we go to shop and then we buy impulsively things that we don't need because they are advertising them. And the moment your eyes fall on them, the bait is there. So if you have not programmed your mind, things that will entice you are always around. It's enticement. Sin will entice. It will entice you. It will project some kind of things that you need. Some kind of happiness, some kind of comfort, some kind of admiration. So it will let you feel that this is what you are looking for. So unless you know exactly what you are looking for, you cannot take your eyes off from the seduction of a man or of a woman or anything. Is it clear?
Yeah. When you go into the Bible, a friend of mine was explaining something. He said I should ask my pastor. He said about Adam and Eve, what God was saying about this Satan tempt Eve.
Mm-hmm.
Using the garden, that particular fruit that they shouldn't eat.
Mm-hmm.
Like, Bible was trying to say about, it was like sex.
So Satan slept with Eve. Like he used forbidden fruit was that apple.
No.
That forbidden fruit. That's he said that is his idea in the Bible. I said no. He said no. That forbidden fruit God was saying was about that.
Bible actually didn't give us the actual name, but the Lord has revealed to brothers and sisters who have been taken to spiritual room that it's a very big, gigantic apple fruit, and it's so juicy and so attractive, very nice and so appealing to the eyes. So the Bible says that, and this after this, Adam knew his wife. Adam knew his wife. Bible never hide anything. Where people cause idolatry, Bible says that, and David slept with Bathsheba. Bible never hide it. It never conceal it. So Bible has a plain language. When a person drank, Noah drank, God say he drank. Yeah, he slept with his children, his daughters, they slept with him. Bible recorded, he didn't hide anything. So, Bible is a very romantic book. When we were reading the book of Ruth, in the last time we were studying the book of Ruth, and you would understand that when when Ruth went to Boaz Naomi told her, don't go very close to him when he is still walking and dancing. But when he has become drunk and he is sleeping and he's lying down, just go and lie at his feet. So that was romantic. And at the end of the day, the whole trap came into successful. Ruth was able to connect to Boaz. And they have a children. So where people don't sleep, how can they have children? Self demonic teaching, sister. That person is demonized.
That's right. Sweet. Amen. Hannah and Elkanah. God said, and then Elkanah knew Hannah clearly.
Yeah,
God did not hide it.
So, all right, Sister Barbara, your hands is up.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
In fact, it's God himself who ordained sex.
Uh-huh.
And he himself said it. He said, you should multiply. Mm-hmm. And there's no other way to multiply than to sleep either a man or to have sex.
Mm.
God himself created it and he made it for both animal creatures who needs to multiply. So God made it for both Adam and Eve and us also. So it isn't sinful. So it's not sinful. It wasn't that was Satan. So God really made sex.
Amen.
He is the one who sanctioned it. Amen.
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 It's not sin. God created it so, and he made all the body parts. Yeah. But we want to say that maybe after eating the fruits, then the consciousness and the awareness of doing it became real. After eating the fruits, then they reduce from human nature, from godly nature to human nature. We don't know if by then animals, they were meeting each other in the Garden of Eden. I don't think they were.
Because they were in pairs.
They were in pairs and they were in a perfect condition. Because in heaven, we don't do the production. So that thing wasn't there. There is a mystery. I've taught this thing. When you go to YouTube, I've got it, the mystery of the fall of man. I've taught that it was in divine plan. The fall of man was a divine plan. After Adam and Eve had fallen, then the awareness to multiply and increase started. Was it sin for them to? Yes, they sin against God. Would that awareness be there? Oh, yes, they would still have been aware of it. Let's raise two children, a young girl and a young man, and put them in a place that no video, no TV, and let them be there. The time will come that the desire to make babies will come upon them at a certain point in time. Nobody will tell them they can do that. Because sometimes one will be feeling sad and will draw you closer. And the more you draw the person closer to your heart, I mean, there is something that it is chemically, it disconnects. And that is why if the person is not your mother, the person is not your wife, the person is not your sister, be very careful how close intimately you can come. Because you put yourself into trouble. God have designed the body to function like that. Most of us, if we are aware, we have fallen as a victim to people that have raped us. We have fallen as a victim to people that have misused and abused us because we trusted them and we drew so close. We didn't consider the gap. We came so close. And that is what all this thing that we are talking about is. Let us mind the gap. It is there. Adam fruit and other things has a different role entirely. After eating it, then the desire to come into that position became real. And from there, animals and everybody started producing. It is how God explained to us how man began the from the state of God who don't need to produce by meeting each other. Heaven, God, do miracle, and the production are taking place. Angels, they don't sleep with each other to produce. So in heaven, God does the work. But here on earth, man has to do it with God. So any person that tells you that the forbidden fruit wasn't an apple but a sexual intimate between a husband and wife is a liar. All right, love, you wanted to read something for us? Are you still there? All right, then. Let's continue. What we were trying to study so far is we are enticed with lustful desire, and the lust will conceive, it will yield its fruits, and sin will be birthed or will be committed, and death is the final result. It happened in the Garden of Eden. It happened in the quotation that Mama Lucy read, 1 John chapter 1. When we are enticed, there is chapter 2, there is always hidden agenda that comes after. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We want to say that Satan will not only seek the permission of God to attack us through temptation. He may also use the power of suggestion to move you away from the will of God. He brings suggestions, ideas. Let's join Matthew chapter 16. Understand the strategy of the enemy. Matthew chapter 16. Today there is no question coming from the Facebook friends or viewers. Meaning they are enjoying it without question. Matthew 16. Yes, Mama?
Yes.
Verses number 21 to 23.
21 to 23. Matthew chapter 16:21-23. From that time forth began Jesus show unto his disciples how that he must go unto Jerusalem and suffer many things of the elders and chief priests and scribes, and be killed, and be raised again the third day. 22. Then Peter took him and began to rebuke him, saying, Be it far from thee, Lord, this shall not be unto thee. 23. But he turned and said unto Peter, Get thee behind me, Satan, thou art an offense unto me, for thou sowest not the things that be of God, but those that be of men.
Hallelujah. Temptation doesn't seek the things of God, but it seeks the things of man. Satan is the tempter all the time. Whenever he comes, he doesn't seek the things of God. So Jesus, this is the other part of the story, what we read from Luke chapter 22. Matthew chapter 16 also is the same line. They were in the same episode, the same situation where they reached, and Jesus made it known to Peter what is about to happen to him. Peter had just received the recommendation from Jesus Christ by divine revelation that God has revealed to Peter who Jesus Christ is. Jesus has walked with the disciples all this while, and then he asked them, who do people say that I am? And they've all brought their views. And then Jesus said, what about you? What do you know about me? Peter was the only one that had the boldness and the courage to come out and say that. I didn't say that Peter was the only one who knew it. All of them knew it. But Peter was the only one who came out boldly and said, Lord, you are Christ, the sent one. We are the Messiah. Today is Palm Sunday. People are celebrating Palm Sunday. When we were little children, we go out running around, singing and shouting. We did it without meaning. We don't go out again. But we dwell within our hearts and worship God because He is the King of Kings in our hearts. So Peter came out and said, Lord, you are the sent one, the Messiah. And Jesus recommended him. Well done, Peter. Flesh and blood has not revealed this. But I'm telling you, I'm going to build my church. And the gates of hate can never prevail against it. I say, Peter, upon this rock. When Peter heard that, Bible dictionary tells us the name of Peter comes from the word Petros, meaning that rock. Small stones, small rocks. So when Jesus said, Peter, I am going to build my church upon the rock, Peter said, oh yeah, hey, I am the foundation. Immediately Satan entered unto him. And Jesus started telling, I'm going to die. Peter took him aside. Lord, why are you saying all these things? You shouldn't say this in public, you know. You can't say this. I mean, why? Peter took Jesus aside and rebuked him. Can you understand you rebuking your father? Well, maybe your father have told you, I'm going to marry another woman. For that one, you can rebuke him. Maybe your father is saying that I'm going to bring another maid into this house because this maid is not good. And your father fancy a lady and you're afraid that daddy will do sin. So daddy, you can't do this. No, we are here. We don't need a maid in this house. You can rebuke your dad. But not when your dad wants to do the goodwill. So here Peter thought that he had the right to do so. And that is where it is. When we feel that we have the right to do so, Satan will seek the power of suggestions and thoughts to influence our heart to sin against God unknowingly. Hallelujah. Suggestions. When we say suggestions, what do you understand, Sister Ifia? Satan can use our suggestions. What does it mean? Is Sister Ifia there?
Brother Gabriel, yes, please. You said sorry.
When,
what was your question again?
The question is, we are saying that Satan can use suggestions.
Mm-hmm.
He can use suggestion as a power to gain entrance into our life and destroy us. So when do we say suggestion? How, in which way does Satan bring suggestions and some thoughts into us that can destroy our relationship with God?
I would say, for example, an idea or maybe plan, for example. Yeah, an idea, for example, like, for example, you have your ideas planned, you know, already, and you felt, okay, this is what you wanted to do. This is what you thought of doing.
Mm-hmm.
And then suddenly you just have a different idea, some kind of a different thought. You just wanted to change your ideas. But meanwhile, for all you know, what you actually planned before might be the right one.
Mm.
But at this point, you keep yourselves in shambles. You just keep yourself in confusion, and then it ends up into something else.
Mm.
It's like with my elder sister, you might advise her and tell her something today, just a few minutes, then she'll just go and change her mind and say, I think I just do not want to involve myself in that. Let me just have my own time and think about it, and I'll let you know some other time. That's how she is.
Mm.
Exactly. So talking about suggestions, I know that is typically going to my elder sister.
Amen. Suggestions. All right. Who wants to comment on suggestion? Auntie Barbara. suggestions and thoughts, Satan can use them as a weapon to fight against us, because sometimes we think that it's coming from us. Sometimes it's an intuition, something coming from within you. Today, I think I said in the church, you must be able to challenge whatsoever you think, whatsoever you feel. Challenge them. If the source is from God. Because sometimes Christians, we think that everything that comes spontaneously in us is coming from the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit told me to do this. The Holy Spirit told me, the Lord told me to do this. Most of the Lord told, it is coming from our inner soul. It is not from God. Okay, so Abrabra.
Hallelujah. Amen. Sometimes suggest things like somebody did something to you, and at that particular time you didn't react negatively, you know, you let it go. Then after that, then the thought will be coming, why didn't you reply her this way? Then you start going over it over and over, and you can see that the suggestion, in natural fact, it's negative. It's not like it's really, and it, the more you keep doing that, or the more that thought or the suggestion comes, the more it irritates you. So you know that source, that it's not from, it's directly from the devil. So that's what I can say.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Sister Lucrece, what do you want to say about this?
Well, I actually wanted to share something that happened to me this morning.
Go ahead, Alan.
While you preached this during the sermon, because yesterday I was longing, you know, to hear from God, because sometimes you just want that intimacy with the Lord, and you want to hear back from Him. You want to know if you are still on that right path, if He's pleasing, you know, to you. And I slept at about 5 in the morning, and I was just crying and just praying on my bed, and I was just, you know, longing for God. I wanted to hear His voice. And then after 9, I was still sleeping, and I heard a lot of things. And when you talked about you need to challenge whether it's your thinking and anything, but for me, I knew that God answered me that morning, because He gave me 2 passages in the Bible. And one was from Jeremiah, and the other one is on 1 Timothy 4, verse 6. And I was so sleepy, because there's a lot of things that He said to me, but then I even forgot the chapter about Jeremiah, but I hold on to this 1 Timothy 4:6, and I type it quickly on my phone, but I didn't want to wake up, because I wanted to keep on listening to God's direction, what He wants, you know, what He wants me to do or to tell me, and to be aware. And in general, it was telling me about the tribulation to come, to stand firm and just carry on, you know. And when I went this morning, when I woke up, I read that passage in 1 Timothy 4:6, and I was amazed how, you know, He truly answered me, because I wanted to know, you know, whether I'm doing the right things, you know. Am I praying you the way I should? Am I, you know, doing everything? And that, if you guys read it, it's amazing. And I want to share with you, maybe it's not just for me, that 1 Timothy 4:6.
Amen.
So, I really thank the Lord for that message, for that confirmation, because I wanted to be reassured. I wanted to have the confirmation. And what you said this morning just kind of confirmed the whole things, because you said if you don't hear from God for 2-3 days, I mean, go on fast and everything. And for me, I needed that. And I was just so happy, and I cried more and more things in the sermon. And I was just so, I praised the Lord for listening to me and answered me. And I just, I'm so happy.
Amen.
I thank God that He brought me here, because the doctrine, because if you read 1 Timothy 4:6, He says, hold on to what you have learned. So, and I believe is, you know, He has directed me to the right path. You know, what I'm listening, what I'm learning is, it's good for me. So,
amen.
This is
the confirmation and affirmation that bring peace.
Amen.
So yes. If thou put the brethren into remembrance of these things, so thou shalt be a good minister of Jesus Christ. And that's what we are doing here.
Amen. Yes.
You're putting people into remembrance.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. And nourishing up in the word of faith and good doctrines.
Mm-hmm.
All that we are doing is we are feeding ourselves in the word of faith and good doctrines.
Yeah, and so, he's telling me to carry on and hold on to that. So
it's not only for you, but for us also. Amen.
Yes. So yes, I just want to hide it and keep it for myself, and I believe that was for all of us who fellowship here.
Amen.
So, but the one in Jeremiah, I plead below, please forgive me and to remind me the exact, but because there was so many things, and I heard the word tribulation, what, you know, just what's to come. So we just have to stand firm and press on. Amen.
And that is what we are preparing for. Tribulation will come, but when our faith and our confidence is stayed upon the word of God, Satan cannot use our mind. Satan cannot play up with our feelings and our emotion and to take us away. Amen.
Amen. Yes.
So what we are doing here, please get involved. Get involved and do your best. Satan will play up with our minds. Yes. Now, sister Barbara finally said, sometimes after you have, and Sister Efia also said, that after you have spoken certain thing with people, agreement has been made. And when you go home, then there's so many thoughts are bombarding you. You feel so disappointed. Next week we talk about that, the stink of the enemy after those things. You feel very sad, very depressed. Why did I do what I did? Sometimes there are stings of the enemy to pull us away from the decision that we have made of God. He will never let you feel comfortable. We're going to talk about other things. But finally, let's finish this one. Let's finish this one to understand the strategy. He may try to cripple your effectiveness through confusion, discouragement, and despair. Did you hear that? Next week, we are going to go deeper into that. Satan will try to cripple with confusion. Somebody will come and sell you something after you have bought what is good. Satan will always sell counterfeit to people after you have bought what is good. He will let you feel that what you are having is wrong. You should have had this one. But if you remain in where you have been called, Apostle Paul told Timothy, remain in what you have been called. Practice it because you know who have called you and what he has called you for.
Amen.
Let's read 2 Corinthians chapter 4. 2 Corinthians 4. As we gradually bring in our studies to an end, we have 20 minutes to go. Today we close exactly at the time. So we use the next 10 minutes, and then the rest 10 minutes we will pray. 2 Corinthians chapter 2. Mama, are you there?
Yes.
Please, chapter 4, I said. Yes. Verse 8 to 9.
2 Corinthians chapter 4.
Uh-huh.
Verse 8 to 9. I read it.
Amen.
It says, we are troubled on every side.
Are troubled on every side.
Yet not distressed.
We are not being distressed.
We are perplexed.
We are perplexed.
But not in despair.
We are not in despair.
Persecuted.
We are being persecuted.
But not forsaken.
We are not being forsaken.
Cast down.
We are cast down.
But not destroyed.
But we are not destroyed.
Amen.
Amen. Wow. What a bullet that Satan threw on us. Number one. Bring your ideas here and your understanding here. We are troubled on every side. What does the word trouble mean? Sister Farida? Being troubled.
You're confused. You don't know what to do.
You are confused, you don't know what to do. Troubled. Trouble wins. We use the word trouble wins. Who is going to answer the first question here? We come back to Sister Esther, and then we come to Sister Vic. Troubled, being troubled. I am troubled.
You are not at rest.
You are not at rest. A position where you are not at rest. You're going out working and all, or what is it, Sister Esther?
Being afflicted.
Being afflicted, being troubled. Sister Vic?
Being disturbed.
Being disturbed. You lost your peace. Being disturbed. Sister Linda, you are being troubled. Auntie Linda, are you there?
Yeah.
What does it mean to be troubled?
To be troubled.
You hear a message?
Confused?
To become confused, being troubled, it's a combination of all kinds of things.
But God, we are being pressed.
Being pressed.
But then we never get confused to the end. You know, no matter how much someone pressed you, you never vanished. You will be there. So.
Amen.
Amen.
Persecuted.
We come back to all this word. So what you are saying, hopefully you are not going to repeat yourself. These are the stings of the enemy. He throws them. Comes unto us. Number one, troubled. You lose your peace. Mama, what do you understand being troubled? Estates.
Thinking too much.
You are thinking too much, okay? Worries. Anxieties. You'll be thinking too much. When you are being troubled, your thoughts go too far.
Yeah.
You can't think far anymore.
You can't think far.
You can't think far. Sometimes your mind will be blocked. Looking for suggestion. Looking for somebody.
It goes blank.
Right. Sometimes you can't think anymore. Mm-hmm. Being troubled. It is one of the things. We'll talk about that next week deeper. Number two. He says, we are not distressed. You know, trouble brings distress.
Yes.
Distress. I thought that when you are being stressed is a bad word. But now he's saying you are being distressed. In other words, Satan will trouble you, but it will not affect you. What does it mean to be distressed?
Distressed.
You don't have rest.
Restless.
Situation.
No more hope.
No more hope. Being
you
distressed. Sister Ifia, what does it mean to be distressed?
It's to cause or to worry, or even as you said before, to be troubled as well. To be troubled as well or to worry.
We don't allow those things to take our peace away. We don't allow those things to affect our foundation that we stand on, because Satan will attack your foundation. It's the anchor that he is after. When tsunami comes, no anchor can stand. The trouble will wage like a rough winds. But when our anchor is established on a pure foundation, this is what Brother Paul was saying. We are being troubled on every side, yet not distressed. We are perplexed. What does it mean to be perplexed? Perplexed.
Confused. Being all over the place.
You're confused. Sorry?
Cooling down.
Troubled mind.
It's a state of being confused. A state of not being stable minded. Yeah? Perplexed. So we are perplexed, but not in despair. What does it mean to be despair, Sister Esther? Despair.
Not discouraged. Destroyed. Despair.
Sister Esther?
Yes, Pastor.
What does it mean not...
My phone is on charge.
Oh, sorry. To despair.
To dispel. Please, someone can help me.
Let me try to help her. A cause of hopelessness.
Please, teacher, please help me.
All right.
Well, to be despair is a cause of hopelessness.
Mm.
Yes.
Yeah.
You lose hope.
You lose hope.
To despair. Yeah. I mean, all hope is gone.
It's gone. Mm. Finito.
There is nothing to hold on any longer. We are not despair. Satan will throw all of them on us. The secret is this. So a man of God that I used to read his books, and his books have really helped me. His name was called Rejoiner. And he was taken to this thing that we are studying. I think through him that this message birthed out when I was reading one of his book, Understanding the Spiritual Warfare, the Strategy of the Enemy. He said, the army of the devil, they are always throwing their spear. They are casting them out. They are firing that. They are throwing them. There are a few groups. There are some people who are ahead. They are so focused and they are so down to earth that all that the enemy is throwing at them, they don't see it. Once Satan throw it, it passes by because they are focusing on the journey ahead of them. They don't give the attention to sin. They don't give attention to what people think. They're not giving the attention to what Satan is bringing their way. They don't give attention to what they have and what they don't have. What they need, what they must have. Their certificate, their education, the husband, the wife, the children, the lack of job. They don't give attention to that. Sister Ifya will say they don't mind what? They don't care.
Yeah.
They don't care. These are the Christians who have determined and decided that I'm not allowed any other thing to affect my relationship with God. Amen. Nothing. 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 Amen. Nothing except death that can separate me from this life and separate me to God. And he said there is another group. Those group, the second group, the spear sometimes touches them. Because these are the people, they are there for their own benefits. So they are the pastors and the leaders who are there. Bless me, people, and want people to be blessed. So such people, Satan throw his firing darts and affect them. There is another group also. When the one that passes by, those who are in front of them, they think that it is those who are in front of them who threw it at them. So they will pick it and throw it at those in front of them. Why are you throwing this thing to us? Why are you doing this? They don't know the source of their problem. They think that the people, humanity, family members, husband, friends are the cause of their problem. So there are group. In a church, we have different types of groups of people who are receiving the battle. Those who are not being affected are those who challenge God and say, God, I have served you for all these years. Sadrach, Meshach, and Abednego group. They told King Nebuchadnezzar, you know what? We don't have anything to talk about this issue. It's not something we should discuss. Sorry for that. We are not being disrespectful, but we want you to know that this thing is not negotiable. We don't come into the table. You want us to come to the table? No, we're sorry. You continue to do whatever you want to do. Because our God, nothing will change our mind.
Amen.
And the king became furious.
Strong one.
He became very... And when Satan fills a person's heart, everything that he does is stupidity. Not knowing that the king is building something to destroy his own people. Not some... Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. It wasn't for the Jewish boys. So Christians, we must be well defined. We must be well focused. We need to understand the source and the reason of the attacks that comes upon us. As Lau said from the beginning, we will be attacked by the word of God that we have decided to follow. Make it a point. And every one of us can assume excellency. Every one of us can have it. Every one of us. Either educated or non-educated, children or adults, we can assume excellence life in Christ. Number one, we must decide. Number two, we need to determine. Number three, we need to dream after it every day. And the desire is the driving force that drives us every day to go forward. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back. No turning back. We can't follow God and do follow our own thing.
No.
Sometimes we don't respect the atmosphere of God. We become distracted. Some of us, we think that we are pursuing God. But one way or the other, we have allowed the enemy to take our mind from where God wants us to things that are not necessary. We want to talk to God. That help me to stay focused. Help me to stay focused. Doing two things at the same time is very distractive. And if Satan wants to take your mind away from God, that's what he does. You may think that you are doing something to benefit the will of God. You can't help God. You can't help. Let's you and me come before God. We become so occupied with so many things. We become so occupied with so many things which are unnecessary. And they steal away the time and the period that we need to have a nice time with the Lord. We allow those things as things that Satan used as bait to distract us from God. Talk to God. The Lord, let me surrender my time, my will. Let me surrender my ways unto you, that your will grow in us. In the name of Jesus, let's talk to God. Father, I surrender my ways to you. I surrender my mind, my spirit, my feelings, my body. I surrender everything unto you. In the name of Jesus, I solely dedicate my heart. I bring my mind and my will to you, O God. For I know that you are the only one who have the right words. You are the only one who have the right thing, O God. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. Let me be well defined. Let me be well defined, O God. That I will not give in to the deception of the enemy. That I will not give in to the plans of the enemy. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. My body is your sanctuary, O God. My body is your sanctuary, O God. Therefore, I submit my life. I submit my will. I submit my ways. I submit my plans to you, O God. I leave it in your hands. I leave it in your hands. For I know that you are able. You are able to take good care of me. I want to put my trust and my confidence in you. I want to put my trust and my confidence in you. For I know that you are more than able to take good care of me. In the name of Jesus. In the name of, let's dedicate our life and say, Lord, if I give you my life, I know you will take good care of it. If I give you my heart, I know you will take good care of it. If I give you my will, I know you will take good care of it. If I give you my problems, I know you will take good care of it. If I give you my anxiety, if I give you my worries, I know you will take good care of it. I dedicate my soul to you. And I know you will, because you determine your desire. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, I make you the Lord over my soul. I make you the Lord over my mind. I make you the Lord over my will. I make you the Lord over my feelings, my emotion, my desire. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Bita de debosi bala mama yanda makola baba yanda lekala suturo boshi kabora stataya. My life belongs to you, O God. My mind belongs to you, O God. My will belongs to you, O God. I dedicate it solely unto you. I dedicate it solely unto you, O God. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Oh, now let us come against every thought, every suggestion, and every idea that Satan brings on our way to cause us to lose our faith in God. Talk to God. Father, today I destroy every division spirit. I destroy everything that distorts my relationship with you. I come against it in Jesus' name. I demolish every works of the enemy against my faith. I dismantle every plot of the enemy against my life. In the mighty name of Jesus. Musa tera makoda yi bababa. Hey, na makoda. Jesus. Glory, hallelujah. Thank you. I surrender my life to you. I surrender my will to you. I surrender my ways to you. I surrender my desire. I surrender my purpose. And I make you the Lord over them. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Any battle, spiritual battle that you are fighting, dedicate the battle also unto the Lord. Dedicate your desire, your feelings, your emotion. Thing that you want to become, thing that you want to have. It might be a husband, it might be a wife, it must be a child, it might be finances, it might be a work. Say, Lord, I give you owner of it. Take it and let me be free. Take it and let me be taken away from them in the name of Jesus. Any stings and fiery darts of the enemy. Any stings and fiery darts of the enemy. In the mighty name of Jesus. We are coming out of it. We are coming out of it in the name of Jesus. I am coming out. I am coming out. Coming out. I'm coming out. You are coming out. You are coming out of the traps of the enemy. You are coming out of the strangles of the enemy. You are setting yourself loose in the name of Jesus. Anything that has bound you not to serve God, pray. Anything which is binding you not to serve God devotedly, set yourself free. From every thought, every feeling, every emotion, set yourself free in the name of Jesus. Say, I set myself free from every bondage. I set myself free from any contamination. I set myself free from every power or force that fight against me. In the name of Jesus. I am setting myself free in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus. Makorobo shikataya. Lanterebo sibra kotorobo shampa. You are my help, O God. My help comes from you. My help comes from you. In Jesus' name. We bring deliverance to people in their homes. I bring deliverance to you in your home. Jesus is about to set you free. In the name of Jesus. Now let us begin to pray and intercede for people who are bound in sin. People who are bound in sin. Let us set them free. People who are blind in spiritual things. Let us give them spiritual eyes. In the name of Jesus. Father, we set the generation free. From any lukewarmness. And falsehood. And the plot of the enemy that have gripped people, oh God. We set them free in Jesus' name. Let your people be set free. Let your people be set free of sin. Be set free of homosexuality, lesbianism, lies. In the name of Jesus. Be thou set free in Jesus' name. Him that the Son set free shall be free. Him that the Son set free shall be free. Approval addiction. Seeking people's approval. Seeking men's favor. We seek your favor only. We alone are God. In the name of Jesus. Matorobo sika biliandaraba. Sheke dededebo sinande lebo kala mama imama. Hela la mama sindaya. Thank you, Jesus. Finally, we want to pray for our family members who are walking in lies. They think that they are going to church, but they are not fellowshipping God. One thing that we know is that any person who is not following holiness, righteousness, and truth is not a believer. That is what the Word of God says. Now people are being given modern Christianity. They modernize everything. Christianity can never be modernized because God can never be modernized. He is an ancient of days. As he was yesterday, so will he be tomorrow. Our God never changes. Shall we pray for our brothers and sisters, our family members who are locked up, who are tied up in sin, and yet they claim that they are Christian. Let's pray for them. In the name of Jesus, and break every power of lust. Destroy every temptation that people allow to come to themselves. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Lord, we set your people free. Lord, we set your people free. Bring them in the land of liberty. We bring them in the land of liberty. We set them loose. We set them free. We set them free. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. We cast down every imagination. We cast down every provision of the enemy, oh God. Substantial provision that Satan has given people in your place, oh God. That never satisfy. That never bring redemption. That never lead to fulfillment. Father, in the name of Jesus, let your people be free in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Finally, put your hands on your heart and say, Jesus, my heart belongs to you. My mind belongs to you. I dedicate my will to you. If you can use me at this end time to let people be know who you are, you can use me, Lord. Everything within me cries, you are mine and I'm yours. Listen to me, Satan. I have decided to follow Jesus, and nothing can change it. My mind is set, my heart is ready. My will is the will of God. Lord, I thank you.
Lord, I thank you so much.
In Jesus' name. For those brothers and sisters who are watching on Facebook, if today is the first day that you are participating in our studies, we want to tell you that we do it every Sunday and every Friday evening at the same time, 8 o'clock to 10 o'clock UK time. So follow us. Besides that, we have so many videos on Facebook that you can go and watch from Love Adade or Gabriel Adade. If you're on Facebook friend, if you're not Facebook friend, why don't you join to become a Facebook friend? You're welcome. Besides that, I got so many videos on YouTube 24/7. You can listen to these videos. They are rich materials that are preparing people for heaven and hell. Besides that, I got my own end time radio. Call End Time Radio UK. You can listen to that radio 24/7. Mama Lucy also is now producing three versions. I've limited my teachings into English. So if you're on Facebook, go to Lucy Owusu Efriye. Tap that one, Lucy Owusu Efriye. If you want to listen to some of our teachings on three, you can listen to that on three, Ghanaian language. Those of you who are familiar with Ghanaian language, I haven't gone there because it will reduce me to only Ghanaians. That is why I don't do it in the local language. But Mama Lucy is there. Besides that, Mama Lucy and my wife and the sisters here in Leicester, we do every day, morning and evening. 5 o'clock in the morning, dawn to 6 o'clock is prayer time. And 9 o'clock, 11 o'clock is Bible studies time. If you want to study the word of God with us, we have international line that we can give it to you. If you are listening to us, wherever you are listening to us, we have materials that we have printed to give out to people on the streets. So if you want to be a distributor of the materials, it is not a church, it's a fellowship. Every person, and it is non-denominational, everywhere you are, you can join the fellowship. We don't want to know that you are part of us. We want to know that you are part of God. It is not necessary for you to reveal yourself. It will help us to know that we have somebody that we are linking up with. But it is not necessary for us to know the number of people we have. But all that matter is that you give your heart to God. I challenge you to serve God sincerely. I challenge you to give all your heart and your time, the rest of your time now, give it to God. Those of you who have studied, those of you who are married, and in all relationships that you have allowed those things to take away the joy and the relationship with God that you have, please give the rest of your life to God. And God will bless you. If you are listening to us and you don't know Jesus Christ, why don't you pray this prayer? and confess Jesus as your personal Savior. Seek water baptism and the Holy Spirit baptism and join us 24/7. Let's pray together with them. Say, Jesus.
Jesus,
I believe you are the Son of God.
I believe you died for my sins.
Lord, forgive me of my sin. Tell God that sin that you want him to forgive you of, and I repent of them. Lord, I welcome you into my life. To be my Lord and my Savior. In Jesus' name. Please give me your Holy Spirit. Please give me your mind. And I will serve you the rest of my days. In Jesus' name. Amen. Sister Jennifer has requested for the international line to join the morning devotion. Sister Jennifer, we will reach you and give it to you. I'll give the number to you on WhatsApp. The Italy one. So Jennifer is in Italy. She has requested for that one. We will give it to her in that one. So that is it. Shall we all share the grace of God together now? May the grace of our Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives. We shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Amen. God bless you all for joining us. Sister Lucrece from France. Sister Ifia from Germany. Sister Esther from Spain. Sister Barbara from London. Sister Vic from Leicester. And Sister Linda, Mama Lucy, Sister Love, Sister Farida. God bless you. Chocolates.
God bless you more.
And all brothers and sisters
you,
on Facebook.
Sisters,
we love you.
Love you too.
Jennifer,
bye.
We love you.
Bye.
Brother George, God bless all of you who watch. God bless you. Amen.